हेलो। हाँ सर, गुड मॉर्निंग।
हाँ, गुड मॉर्निंग। मैं ऑडिबल?
यस सर, यस।
ओके, थैंक यू।
यस, 11 o'clock।
हेलो विपिन सर, हाउ आर यू? हाँ सर, हाँ सर, हाँ बिल्कुल।
Hello. Hello, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Good morning, respected dignitaries and delegates. I'm Mrs. Paras Savalia, Assistant Professor and HOD of Obstetric and Gynecological Nursing Department, Ninsa Patel College of Nursing, Nadiad. I welcome you all in this webinar as a faculty development program organized by IQAC DPCN. A learning management system, LMS, is a software application for the administration, documentation, tracking, reporting, automation, and delivery of educational courses, training programs, or learning and development programs. The learning management system concept emerged directly from e-learning. An LMS delivers and manages all types of content, including video, courses and documents in the education and higher education. There are several historical phases of distance education that precedes the development of the LMS. Correspondence teaching, multimedia teaching, telemetric teaching, and teaching through the internet, which we are doing right now. The appearance of the first LMS. Now I would like to invite Mr. Virendra Jain sir, Principal Ninsa Patel College of Nursing, Nadiad, to welcome our today's resource person. Yes, sir.
Good morning, all of you. Thank you, Ms. Paras.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning. My voice is audible, please.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Thank you. Good morning, all of you, and Jai Maharaj. I look forward to all the participants are safe and happy and doing tremendous effort in this difficult time, COVID-19 pandemic. On behalf of Ninsa Patel College of Nursing, I heartily welcome all the participants, faculties, and YouTube viewers for registering and joining this webinar. On behalf of Ninsa Patel College of Nursing, it is my great pleasure and honor to extend a warm welcome.
Sir, he's the assistant.
Is the assistant professor from Department of IT and CSIPT, Charsat University, Changa. I welcome you, sir, for this webinar. I especially welcome all the DPCN faculties from various institutions for showing their interest to attend this webinar. The purpose of organizing this webinar, how we can give the best and effective teaching and learning methods to our students in this pandemic situations. And I'm sure today we will expand our knowledge regarding the preparation of e-courses, videos, lectures, and demonstrations. Once again, I welcome you all. Over to you, Ms. Paras. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. To enhance our knowledge in this topic, LMS, preparation of e-courses, videos, lectures, and demonstrations, we are glad to have an eminent personality in IT profession, Mr. Nirav Bhatt, sir. Before sir comment his expert talk, we will have some glimpse of his career in IT profession. Sir has completed M.Tech, Computer Engineering, and right now sir is pursuing PhD. Sir is Assistant Professor at Department of IT, Chandubhai S. Patel Institute of Technology, Charusat. Sir is Coordinator of Spoke Charusat for Swayam NPTEL Local Chapter. Sir has 13 years of huge experience in IT field. Sir has various Microsoft certification like MTA Database Fundamentals, NPTEL Certification for Database System from NPTEL IIT Madras. Sir is awarded for AAA, AA, and A grade by IIT Madras for massive open online courses that MOOC coordination for NPTEL local chapter. Sir conducted expert talk and seminar at NPTEL local chapter and online courses IQAC cell at MS University, Baroda, NPTEL MOOC for PD Patel Institute of Applied Sciences, Charuset, BVM Engineering College, Vallabh Vidyanagar, Adani Institute of Technology, Ahmedabad, and Sumandip Nursing College, Vadodara. Sir, we feel blessed with your presence. And now I would like, sir, for invite sir for the expert talk. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for your warm introduction. Good morning, all of you. I hope I am audible. Am I audible?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So good morning and welcome all of you. I'm glad to be a part of this webinar and get a chance to discuss with you as one of the reputed institute situated in Nadiad Nursing Institute. As you all are aware that the topic which we are going to discuss in the next hour of session is regarding the LMS. Right. I would like to share my screen and show you the presentation which I have prepared for you, and hope this will be helpful to all of you. Is the presentation visible to all of you?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Thank you. So, LMS, the learning management system, and specifically the content which we are going to discuss today is regarding the preparation of e-courses, videos, lectures, and demonstrations, right? So I have planned to conduct this session in this way that I would like to show and discuss with you regarding the tools for teacher and student communications, that how the teacher and students will be communicated through a well-known tools and how it will be useful to you as well as students. And then there will be a tools for learning. So that will be e-learning. Now this learning is not only for the student point of view, this is also for the faculty point of view. And then there are certain tools for teaching. That is where maybe you are interested in e-content delivery, right? How we can deliver our e-content effectively on sir, using some different tools and technology. So this is how I have planned to conduct the session. So let us start with the first, that is tools for the teacher and student communication. Now you might be aware about many tools and you might be are using also, because as we all are doing the teaching learning activity online nowadays, right? So you might have used certain tools out of this. So first and very effective tool which generally used by the people in the academics are the Google Classroom. And maybe you are also aware about it, and maybe you are also using it. So Google Classroom, if you are not aware about, let me tell you very quickly about this. That is one of the effective tool which you can use for communications with the students, where you can store your all communication and conversations. And it is like a virtual classroom, right? As physical classrooms are not nowadays possible, we can create a virtual classroom where we and students can be communicated with each other. The best part of it is you can log in with your existing Google credentials. So if you have a Gmail, then you can use it to just log in into the Google Classroom, the link which is provided here. And once you log in, this is one snapshot which I have attached here, that how it looks like a Google Classroom, how it looks like. Once you log in, you will have a choice of either joining a class or creating a class. So here you can see that there will be a symbol plus. When you click on this plus, you will get two choices, whether you want to join some existing class. So basically, if you are a student, you may join the class using the join class. Or if you are a teacher, you are interested in creating a class. So if you just click on creating a class, it will allow you to create a new class with a specific name. So here are the sample classes which I have created. This is my Google Classroom that you can see, just a snapshot, right? So the course-wise classes are created, and you can see the number of students who are in this particular class, right? And whatever conversations you do with this class will remain there throughout the lifetime till your account is active. It's not like that this is a temporary class which I have created. This is long-term connections with the students and as well as teacher, right? Okay, so by creating a class, once you create a class, what the first thing that will happen to you is you will have a particular class code which you require to share with your students. And once you share that with your students, students can use that for joining that particular class. When they click on join class, they will immediately ask to enter the class code which is provided by the teacher, and that class code will be then so here that particular class code will be provided to the student, and that by entering the class code they can enter into the particular class. Or another way is you being a teacher have an authority that after creating a class you will have one operations called invite students, where you have to invite the students through their email ID, where you have to provide your email ID to the where you have to enter the email ID of the students if you are aware about. And that email will goes directly to the students, and students will click on that and directly be a part of this class. Now, there are so many things that we can do using this class, which I'm not going to conduct right now because it will take one another session that what are the things that you can do. But I will make a summary of it that what you can do is you can add an announcement as well as materials if you have with. So as soon as you know that nowadays most of us have a smartphones and the Google account is configured into the smartphone. As soon as you add the announcement or the lesson materials, the notifications will be given to the students through their mobile also, right? So that's how they will be, keep updated with the latest updates available in the Google Classroom, right? You can also add an assignments, and regarding those assignments, you can also give your grades, and that will be visualized to them. And we can keep all these things into at one place. So we can provide materials, give assignments, take certain sessions, and then we can grade those assignments. And at the end, the best part and the best part of this Google is a Google quiz. You can also take a quiz. And this quiz definitely will allow you to upload your own Google Forms. You have created a Google Form or a quiz through the Google Form, or you may have any other form. The quiz is available. You can just upload the quiz into the quiz section, and that quiz will be then visualized to all the students of that class, and they can attempt that quiz and the grades will be assigned to them. And their statistics will also be generated, like how many students have scored more than 70%, less than 60%, how many of them have passed, how many of them have failed, and all those statistics along with the charts, like bar chart, pie charts, different charts, and their statistics are generated, which you can directly utilize for the document purposes, right? So where the picture will be more clear about the entire class. So that is something which is provided by the Google and it's very effective. So that you can conduct using the Google Classroom, like the quiz you can conduct. Here, regarding this quiz, this Google quiz is so much powerful that even if you want to restrict so many things, you can do. Like suppose if I want to generate a different sets, as I want to restrict the students to copy the quiz, then I make generate a set of quiz, and all those sets will be assigned to the students in a group, so customized group. So for example, set one will be assigned to some random number of students, set two will be assigned to those, set three will be assigned to some other random number of students, and the students are not aware about that, whether they have the same questions or different questions. And you can generate and you can assign those, you can schedule them at the different time, right? Like suppose I want to schedule this, I have already prepared and want to schedule after 1 hour or 2 hour, or for some quiz, for some students it will be tomorrow, for some students it will be day after tomorrow, right? You can schedule, pre-schedule all these things. So that is a very good tool where you can take it. But at the end, student can also write something on our classroom, like if they have a doubt, so they want to ask something. Right. So this announcement is not only for the purpose of faculty, like student can also send you some assignments and materials also, or students can also share their views on the Google Classroom. Right. So that's how it is very useful, and it's almost like a classroom. But students used to come into the class and communicate with you. You can do everything virtually with a Google Classroom. But I hope this is very much, I think you are aware about this, right? We have another tool which is most widely used in the world, which is Edmodo. I have provided a link here. You can, if you are not aware about it, you can just go through it, and you can have. So this is a snapshot which how the Edmodo is look like. It is specifically designed for the teacher, and how the teacher can communicate with the students. Again, this all those same tasks that you can do using Google Classroom, you can do using Edmodo, like add an announcement and assignments. But here you can also do the assignments with a specific deadline. And those who submit after deadline, you can also restrict them that you cannot submit, or if you want to allow, they will submit and there will be a late submissions. There will be a label called late submissions will be assigned to them. So there is some extra facilities which are given in the Edmodo where you can track that how many of the students have submitted the assignments or the quiz on time, how many of them have submitted after the deadline. So that is something called late submissions. You can give your grades as per the criteria, whatever you want to decide. So you can also take a quiz and grade the assignments as well as grade the quiz. So that is also very useful. And here, not only class is created, here groups are also created. In a Google Classroom, you create a class. Here, if you want to create a class, if you think that your class is of, let's say, 50 students, 60 students, or 100 students, it is better to create a class, right? So after login into the Edmodo, you can see that My Classes, where you can just click on these three dots and you will have options like you can create a class or you can join a class. So if you are interested in creating a class, you can create a class with a specific name. But at the same time, we have a facility to create a groups. So here it is a My Groups, and there are three dots. When you click on it, again, the same options, create a groups and join groups will be visible to you, and where you can create your own groups. So this group will be very much limited to like 15 students, 20 students. When you have divided your students into the batches, it's better to have this. And it is a purely a continuous learning and assessment tool. So we use here since many years for the continuous activity, like continuous learning, continuous quiz, and a continuous assessment. We create the groups batch-wise, and we plot a different assignments and quiz to them, and that will be stored there. And we can have at the end statistics and all the documentation which, and as an academician, we require to take a print and store as a part of it. So nowadays, you know that continuous evaluation becomes very much important, because it's like the system of taking an exam at the end of semester, at the end of year, and just evaluating based on that, it is now absolute. So nowadays, what we want is through this kind of effective tools, we should have continuously assess the students, whether they learn or not. Whether they learn every week, whether they learn every month. So every week, every month, we should have certain activities where student has to, and we can assess the students with these activities. So this is purely a continuous learning based. So this is another, which is a second, which is I want to introduce to you, which is Valno, Edmodo. The another and effective tool, which is YouTube Studio, as you might also be aware that right now, YouTube streaming of this Zoom recording is also going on. So through YouTube Studio, you can see the link that you can be live through a live streaming. And once you are live, it is possible that your students can chat with you, and you being live can answer to those chats. That is one of the things that you can do when the audience is very large, right? So generally when the MOOC courses instructors are used to provide live streaming for the doubt solving sessions. Generally you can use it for once you have already taught to the students, and now students have a doubt and they want to communicate in terms of like on the existing sessions, they want to discuss something. You can have one doubt solving session on YouTube where you can be live through a live streaming, and in a chat, one by one, students can plot their questions and you may answer those. And in this way, it's a one of the effective communications tool between the teacher and student. So this is the first thing that which I have introduced in front of you, that how you can be in a continuous touch with the students the classroom, Edmodo, as well as the YouTube. These are the three different way, and based on your purpose, you can utilize it properly. So this is a very generalized tool and most widely used. Another thing which I want to discuss with you is regarding the online tools for learning, that is e-learning. Now, it is not restricted to now students, it is for teacher also. And when it comes to the e-learning, the first thing that that comes into our mind is a MOOC. So you might be, I think, aware about the MOOC courses. If you are not aware about, let me give you a very brief. That is, MOOC is a massive open online courses which are available online. And I think it was not that much popular before this pandemic situations. But after this COVID situations, nowadays the MOOCs are very much popular because the people don't want to stop learning, so they can continue learning through the online course, right? And there are so many online platforms are available with us through which we can be a continuous learner. Okay, now when method of learning is come, it is not only for student, it is for faculty also. Let us see that which is the effective tool available in India for the learning. So one of the effective platform which we have in our country is a Swayam, which is supported by the government of India. So the government of India funded project, which is Swayam, is the only MOOC that our country have its own, and where the foreign university students and faculties can also enroll and can also learn and can also give the exams and can do all these things that a particular course can offer, right? So Swayam is the platform, and this is the website, swayam.government.in. And it is actually a platform. It's not a MOOC, but it's a platform where all the different providers, like our national providers here, you can see that I have highlighted. This national coordinators or the course providers can provide their own course in this platform. So AICTE suppose want to provide their own course, or let's say UGC want to provide their own course, or NPTEL is a technical IITs, the group of IITs want to provide some technical course on it, or any provider, any well-known national provider which is available with us here, which is listed here, they can provide their own course, and we can enroll any of this course which is available to us. It's freely available to us, and we can learn this. So from student point of view, it is moreover learning from the different providers, right? And they all provide different MOOCs, like massive open online course, right? And we can enroll to any specific course. And we can see all those courses through, you can see here in the upper corner, that is all courses tab is given to us, which is blue highlighted here. When you click on those all courses after going to the swayam.government.in, right, you will get all the list of courses which are available right now, and they are upcoming, and the enrollment for that is open. That means anyone can enroll. Faculty as well as student can enroll all those courses, and you will find a list of courses in front of you. Of course, you will also find the national coordinators here, right, which are available. AICT, IGNOU, and so I click on this NPTEL. NPTEL courses will be available in front of you, and then you can click on it and you can join it. It's easy to join the course directly, but you have to just first move on to the Swayam and a specific provider which providing this course, and you can do it, right? So certificates which you will get is definitely from the national coordinator, right? And that will be valid throughout the country, even outside the country, and that is valid for each and every purpose, right? So this is how you can enroll. Now, although NPTEL is more or technical, but when I try to find out for specifically nursing and medical related fields, I come to know that the provider, which is called NPTEL, also provides certain courses, not all the, but certain courses which are useful for specifically nursing and medical related fields. I also highlighted a few of the courses which they offer and which you might be interested in, and you can enroll through a Swayam NPTEL. That is, maybe it's medical biomaterials which is related to that, and where you will be introduced to different medical biomaterials which are useful. Medical image analysis and medical chemistry. The introduction to research, those who are specifically involved in the research. Health research fundamental is most widely used in your field, and most of the students and faculties who are from your field and related fields enroll this course. And this is also one of the regulatory requirements for medical devices, where they introduce different devices, medical devices which are required and the regulatory. That is also a very good course which is offered by the NPTEL. And the course have different duration. Like this is a 4-week course, but this previous one is a 8-week, and some of them are 12-week course, right? So there starts and exam dates and ending dates and everything is there in front of you when you log in the firm. Now, when I've been involved with the SOIAM and NPTEL, because we have established a local chapter 5 years back since, and probably we were the first to establish in India. And I'm continuously in contact with this SOIAM NPTEL team. So when I have communicated with them, they say that generally our purpose or NPTEL purpose is to provide the technical content, but we are right now providing the medical and health related courses, which we found that we have a very good and we can offer. Otherwise, they have requested to ICMR, the Indian Medical Council, so to start their own separate medical courses on SOIAM. So very soon you will also find that ICMR is one of the national provider or a coordinator in the SOIAM to provide the courses which are moreover useful to your fields and medical. As of now, right now it is under the process or under the scrutiny, and it is like we haven't got any acknowledgement or reply to start that ICMR is now allowed to create their own course onto the SOIAM. So till then you can explore through the NPTEL is one of the options. Okay. Now, what exactly happens when we enroll any course through the SOIAM platform, right? So let us see first student point of view. From student point of view, obviously it is a continuous learning and continuous assessment. So there will be an assignment that they have to submit it every week and before the deadline. And there will be a final exam, which is optional, right? And which is, of course, online exams. It is not like a physical exam. Mostly MCQ based online exam, logical question. When it is a matter of assignments, they have to submit, and their scores will be there in their platform. So, and in the final exam also, have a specific course. The division is 25% weightage are generally for the continuous assignment, and 75% is for the certification exam. And that's how the 100% is calculated. The final course is, final score is calculated based on this division. Now, what is the expectation is the student's score, that is in assignment score, they must have to score at least 40% of the total, because 40% is the passing criteria. And even in the final exam also, they also require to have a 40%. And that's how they have an average 40%. So if they have an average 40%, they will be certified by the national coordinators, and that they can show it and to anyone, which will be helpful to them in the future also. Right. So that this is something that what they can do. And again, this exam is optional. That means you can also do one thing, that you can also allow them to enroll. It is free. And let us solve the assignments which are given by the faculties to them. And you also can solve parallelly the assignment. You can solve their doubt. And these assignments you can track, and you can get an information about the status of the particular school. If they give the final exam, then certificates will be given to them. That will be very much useful. That is from the student point of view. It's a very good learning platform where you can learn, right? You can learn the latest tools and technologies also. Okay, now from the faculty point of view, you can also learn. Like we also can learn. We also can enroll the course. So this is one of the courses in which I have enrolled. And I can see that being a faculty, when I enroll, I have one additional advantage that I can be a mentor, and I can see that how many students have selected me as a mentor and how many mentees are there in my list, right? So when I click on the mentee list, I can see that there are number of mentees are there, and what I can track is I can track that they have also enrolled this course, and what are their scores in assignment 0, what are their scores in assignment 1, what are their scores in subsequent assignments. I can track all those assignments, right? So this is just a snapshot of one particular page, but you can do all these things. You can download as a CSV file, and you will have information about their continuous learning and evaluation, right? Where the assignments are plotted by their NPTEL or whatsoever be the provider, but you can also track whether they are doing this continuously or not. Some of them are not doing it, you can intimate them. Like for example, assignment zero was submitted by very few faculties. I can intimate them by being a mentor that now what is the difficulty? Why you are not doing it continuously or what difficulty you find? So being a mentor, I have to be a true mentor and I have to assist them in each and every difficulties with what they are facing, for example, while doing this course. And that's how we can continuously get the progress of it. So being a mentor, what I can do is I can get a mentorship certificate. If I will be an effective mentor and if there are mentees under me who are also submitting the assignments and giving the exams, then additionally, I will be identified as an active mentor. I'll be identified as a top performing mentor based on the scores and I'll be identified as a mentor. And that certificate is a proof for that I'm an active mentor in the such kind of MOOC course. So I teach something extra apart from or I assist my students something extra apart from my regular course. That's a mentorship certificate is one of the advantage for the faculty point of view. I'm talking about when the faculty enroll the course as a faculty and then, right? Apart from that, as we discussed that you can track the assignment score of your students and you can check their progress and help them out to do something more. And one thing is, if you being a faculty have enrolled the course and you are also doing the assignments and you are in a planning to give the final exams, then these courses are generally AICT approved courses that are provided by the NPTEL. What you will get is AICT approved FTP certificates. Like this is also one part of, like this session is also one part of the FTP, right? Similarly, once you do this course, it will be considered as you have completed one FTP, faculty development program, that is approved by the AICT, and you will get a certificate from the AICT that your FTP program for this much week is completed. Because you completed this course, which so-and-so score. This is one thing. Like I would also like to show you the certificate, how it looks like. The certificate will be something like this. The provided by the NPTEL AICT is a faculty development program. Your name will be here. The course name will be here and your score will be here, right? Along with your photographs. And this is the AICT symbol on the NPTELs. This is which is valid all over the India and even outside the country also, right? Because it is provided by the well-known provider or the Government of India approved certification course. And here are the information about these courses are there. If that course is of 4 week, it will be considered as a half FDP. If it will be of 8 week, then it is one FDP. It will be of 12 week, then it will be something like that. So depends on number of weeks, your FDP will be considered of how many weeks of FDP, which is equivalent to this particular course, right? So this is a certificate which you will get once you complete your course along with your student also. Your students will get some same kind of certificate, but that will not be a faculty development program or faculty FDP certificate, right? It will be a pure student oriented. So the only thing that differentiate between the student and faculty is this. But apart from that, faculty can be a mentor and can do so many things, right? Which as a faculty, we always want to, okay. And if you are a mentor, if some mentees, active mentees are there in your mentorship, and if they give the exams and they certified, you will be get a certificate of appreciation. You can also be one of the top performing mentor for your course if you are a mentor, right? The course name is also mentioned. Some statistics regarding the how many mentees are there registered in that particular course and what are their course, how many toppers are there. So for example, in my course, there was one topper all over the India, then it is also mentioned here. And you will get such kind of recognition and rewards from the SWAYAM, right? So that's another advantage that being a mentor, that what you can do through this online platform. So this is what online learning is through always a MOOC. MOOC is the most preferable online learning, and not only for students but also for faculty. But when you do online learning through SWAYAM and NPTEL, being a faculty, you not only learn, you not only certified
for those courses, but you also can be a mentor and you can also get some additional certificates. You can also be involved with activity like student tracking, their progress tracking, and that's how you will be more involved with your students. So that is something which I wanted to highlight with and I wanted to discuss with you. That is, but apart from that, we also have a many different MOOC platform, which is not on from our country, but they are from the outside country, which is also very well known, which is Coursera, EDX, or Stanford University. So they are also providing the very, very effective courses that you can enroll, but those courses are mostly chargeable. So where you have to, you can register for those courses, but you have to pay for this. But they also offer certain kind of courses which you might be interested in. If you are, for example, interested to learn something more advanced, which is not offered through the SWAYAM platform, right? So this is one thing which I wanted to discuss with you, which is MOOC as a part of learning from student as well as from faculty. So this is one thing. Now, one more thing is there where you might be interested and might be more interested is which are the tools and technology for teaching specifically, and it is more related to e-content delivery, and it is more related to faculty only, right? So I would like to start with a very generalized tool which is generally faculties are used for recording their lectures or something like this. So first of the tool that you can use for e-content delivery, or very simple thing you can think of, is there is one well-known tool which is available and people very much using this tool is called APowerSoft, that you can get it from even internet also. And it is basically a screen recorder. Now, what exactly happens is when you present a lecture and if you have something to show and if you have something to record, then you can use this APowerSoft screen recorder. So what it will do is it will record your entire screen. It will record your entire screen. Whatever you do on your screen will be recorded. So for example, if right now I am presenting, the screen is recording, right? Then if I minimize this and if I open some other link, if I open some internet and browser, then it will also be recorded. And for example, if I minimize this and meanwhile I want to communicate with the students in front of, like, I want to show them charts, I want to show them images, and I want to explain them through that, then I can open that. That entire activity, whatever you do with your computer, will be recorded. And that recording then later on you can provide to your students. And that is something called one of the way to provide or deliver the content, right? So for that effective tool and very easy to use tool is APowerSoft screen recorder. It is freely available on internet to download, but free version is limited for certain minutes for the recordings. If you purchase the paid version, then you will have an unlimited recording, unlimited time, and all the facilities which is provided by that screen record. But it is one of the simplest way to record your entire session. If you have multiple things to showcase in your computer and you want to conduct one session using those things, that you can later on provide it as a recording to your students, and that will be one of the e-content delivery you can consider. Another thing is YouTube or YouTube Studio, which we have just discussed a few slides back, that what we can do is we can be a live on YouTube, and live streamings is one of the way to provide the e-content delivery, where regardless of any restrictions of number of users, all the users can join and then they can flood their questions and interact with you specifically through the chat window, right? Okay, apart from that, you also know certain tools which are like, for example, Google Meet, which we are using for conducting our sessions, Zoom, on which right now we are in touch with each other, the Cisco WebEx. These all are the tools which are well-known tools and people are using it for the conducting the sessions, live sessions. So you can use it, but they have certain kind of limitations, like only limited number of users can right now be a part of it. But through YouTube, you can extend it, right? So that's a tool and that you can use it. But if you don't want to be live, if you want to record your sessions, you can go for the APowerSoft screen recorder. Even PowerPoint presentation also has the facility to record the entire presentations, which you can record and you can provide it later on to your students. So there are two ways: either you can be live, or you can be off, or your offline recording can be provided to the students as a part of e-content delivery. But e-content delivery can be done in this way. But that is, there are certain also websites through which you can provide the e-content delivery, and the Swayam, which we have discussed, is one of the website, right? You can develop your own course. Suppose if you want to provide it into the larger audience, like if you consider a nursing related thing, and if you want to provide a one new course in a nursing area, right, or the medical related areas, and if you have enough content and if you have a well-defined contents, and if you want to provide this all content as a one course to enter at, like, it's a very large audience, it's, you are going to provide it at the country level and not only for your limited to your institute or a specific institute, right? Then you can have a development of your own course, and you can upload and you can offer that through a MOOC platform. So we have a Swayam which allow us to do that, right? Which allow us to do that. The only thing is what we have to just check the rules and regulations. So it may happen that first you must be ready with entire content, all the experts and everything, your recordings. Then you need to submit. There are certain forms and formalities are there that you have to be in a contact with Swayam, that you need to submit all those things. They will thoroughly go through all these things and they will approve. Once your course and everything will be approved, then it will be available onto the Swayam platform. And that's how you can, through a global platform, you can provide your course to the global audience, right? If you don't want to provide a course on a global platform, but because it is sometimes difficult to, you know, design one entire course which is newly designed, or maybe the approval which we require to get it from the Swayam is itself a very time consuming, then immediately what you can do is you can have a Moodle at your institute. Now this is specifically used for if you want to provide for your student. If you want to design your own course and want to provide to your students instead of having the online platform, you can offer through your server. If your institute have a very well-defined server, and through, from your institute servers, you want to upload or broadcast your course, then you can do it using the Moodle. Of course, we need some LMS which help us to upload it, right? We have a server. Now we have a course also. Now what we want is some LMS which can, where I can upload all my course materials, content and everything. Well, I can arrange and I can then put it onto my server so that all my students can access through my server, right? So we have those, we have that facility, like server and course content and everything. But then what we require is LMS, one learning platform, learning management system, which is called Moodle, right? Which is available. You can, I have also provided the link here as and when it is required, so that you can download that Moodle, which is freely available. You can download it and you can utilize it. You can customize it. The best and the main part of this Moodle is you have to customize. You have to create your personalized learning environment for your purpose, right? So everyone can download the Moodle, but then you may design your own, or you can create your own environment for your course, and that's how you can offer to your student as well as anyone. Your course will be there. Now it requires somewhat technicality, because those who are most involved in the technical part, they can easily personalize and they can do it, right? But it is not readily available. We have to customize, that is for sure. So let me show you that the Moodle which we have designed, like for example, and we have uploaded in our server also, something like this. This is from my server. I'm accessing the Moodle, right? I have downloaded, and we have, we from Charuset University are providing one online course on PGDCH, right? So let me log in with the admin so that I can showcase certain kinds of features and functionality which is there in the Moodle, and that you can do. So once I log in with the admin, then
Then this is a customized environment of my course. Now this course is available, and this course is available in such a way that anyone in the world can enroll this course and can utilize the content, right? So here on, I have provided the, like, it is a customized. I have provided the calendar here. Then what are the upcoming events? Some files are there, some users are there. As it is an admin, you can see that all the features will be listed here. It is not a student login. If you log in with the student, then obviously you will have a restricted course related content and everything will be there. Okay. You can see the my courses here, where you can have a PGDCH as one of the course and gate is another course. If I click on this course, and then you will find that how this course has been designed, right? This course has all these navigation tabs where you can have all the week-wise sessions I have uploaded here. I have a list of participants also. And you can see that when I click on participants, I have all this participant list. See, these are all the participants who are currently enrolled in our course, who are from Vadodara, from Mumbai, from many different places. And they have already enrolled and they are online learning this particular course called PGDC. University will offer the certificate or based on this, whatever learning has been happening. Right? And it is related to it. There are so many things to explore in this that I'm just giving you a few of the things that what you can do is. And here you can see the overview that there are different lectures are available to you. Now, some of the lectures are already active. Some of the lectures are hidden. These are the hidden lectures. That is lecture number, like week number 22 onwards, everything is hidden. That is not floated to the students right now. Right now, students can see only up to 21. And then after completion of this, I can enable 22, week number 22. And then that's how the continuous learning and then entire course can be completed, right? And then at the end, you can have your quiz. At the end, you can have your exams on this. These all are the administrative point of view, right? And I can show you that how to change all these things. Actually, it requires a lot of technical training that how to use the Moodle and how to customize the Moodle for your own purpose. But we can do it. So for example, if I go to the page, and if I see that, these are where you can edit. Now this is the syllabus which I have added, and discussion forum and everything is I have added here. So that will be a front page. Then week one is right now live, but I can click on edit and I can hide this week. If I hide this week is not visible to the student, right? It is only for my purpose. I have designed it where I have a notes, I have a PPT, I have all this quiz and everything is there. If you want to plot the quiz week-wise, you can do it. You can design your entire course in such a way, right? And you can see all these are the live weeks sessions that are visible to the students, but these are something which are not visible to the students, which I have hidden. And when I click on it, and if I say show week, it will be then live to the students also, then students log in, right? So this is one of the things, but that you can do so many things with the Moodle. It's purely a customized platform. It is freely available. Most of the tasks that what you requires can freely done and can be easily done. But for some of the high level functionality, maybe you require to pay. Otherwise, everything is free, right? You can also conduct a quiz in it. The best part of it is what? If you have a questions, right? Then if you have a questions, you can import also, right? If you want to import your quiz, if you want to define it. So there is a specific format. You can see that these are the text format. Now, if I see this second format, this is a text format which is provided by them. And I have to just upload my question in this text format. The quiz will automatically be formed. We don't have to form a quiz like what we do generally in the Google quiz or Google Forms or Microsoft Forms. We use to conduct a quiz or a test, right? And when it happens, there are multiple options are also there, which you can change as per your requirement. But then you can import your questions and you can prepare your quiz and you can plot this quiz to the students with specific deadline, with specific time, purely a customized LMS. This is considered as an LMS. This is called pure LMS, right? Where one particular person can manage everything which is required for online teaching and learning. That is something which I also wanted to highlight to you. Now, I don't know whether you are aware about Moodle or not, but the Moodle is something, the platform, which anyone can utilize for their purpose, right? So that's why I included as a part of it. And you can, I have also provided a link as and when required so that you can explore more. As you can see that to explore each and every individual tools and technology and to showcase their advantage, is very difficult to conduct in 1 hour sessions, but I try to customize and design in such a way that at least we will be aware about the platforms, the tools and websites which are available and which is very much easy to use, right? I have not added so much technicality or technical things in this presentation just by considering that all the audience will be the from nursing and related backgrounds. I consider that. And I have included only those tools and websites which you can easily use it being a nursing and a medical person, right? And for that, you don't require maybe any difficulty. But suppose if you want to design your own Moodle, right? Then we may help you out to, if you are finding any difficulty. And if you think that let our institute can start a Moodle and can give a course to the, and offer the course through Moodle so that entire course and course related activity will be there online available at one place in your server, right? Instead of manually recording the session and plot it, or instead of, like, for example, every time conducting a Google Meet sessions and Zoom sessions, right? You may have some pre-recorded sessions also. Now, for example, if today you are delivering something, it will be definitely be useful in the next year also, because the next year maybe the students will learn physically. But then you can also give them your recordings. You can design a predefined course, right? And if you need any help in, like, for example, technical help in designing a Moodle or customizing a Moodle or handling the Moodle, right? So we can do it, right? We can handle your entire activity of the course. The only thing that you have to do is what? You have to submit your content. And we will customize everything and we'll do it. Find a difficulty, or if you find that you want to do it, but somewhere the technical constraints are there, we can help you out in that way. So, I specifically convey this to principal sir and the coordinator madam. Future, if you think that or if you require it. Other thing that which I think it's very useful is SlideShare, and you can easily use it, right? Now, SlideShare is a platform which is again a widely used and where people used to upload their slides and presentations, right? And you can easily get it from that. You can easily learn it from that. It's purely in a presentation form. You can have a recording of your entire presentation or maybe your PPT or any presentation content that you can upload onto the SlideShare. And people used to download it from it. They subscribe to your SlideShare account. They download it. They will provide you the feedback. They will provide you the content related feedback or anything like this. They may request for further more content. You can have your entire statistics that how you are live on internet and how the people are you. It will be add something in your profile. That if you have uploaded something on SlideShare, which is most widely used by many faculties and students throughout the country, and they are also subscribing and liking your videos or slides or presentations, and they are also asking the question, and based on that, you have more content to upload or share with them. SlideShare is the another website where I have also given you the link if you are not aware about or if you have never, for example, use it, right? Then you can use from that particular link. Maybe it happens that many of the things might be you are aware about because you are using it, right, in this kind of situation. Some of the things you are not aware about, then useful to you to use it. So that is something which I have designed for you and customized it. So thank you for that. I want that if you have any doubt, any difficulties, or like anything you want to ask something, like, for example, how we can manage, how we can do it, have some question in your mind, let us discuss.
Yes, sir.
I'll be trying my best to answer.
Thank you so much, sir, for your informative live session. Now it's the time for discussion. If anyone wants to ask any question, please write your question in chat box. We will discuss it.
So you may unmute or ask me, or you may write it something in the chat also, and we can see the questions from that end.
Can I ask question, Paras?
Yes, sir. Yes.
Yes. Thank you, sir, for the nice session.
Thank you, sir.
And
thank you.
I would like to ask, sir, questions. There are many purchase software available, like for the teaching and learning.
Mm.
There are many software available. So, as per your experience, sir, there is need to buy software for teaching and learning. There are many agencies. They are approaching to us to purchase this kind of software. And as you said, like the Google Classroom is free available.
So, sir, there are two things. One is, see, if you use Google Classroom, you don't require to purchase anything. You can manage everything through Google Classroom.
Yes, now, sir.
The only thing that what you find difficulty maybe is in, like, how to provide my recordings to the students. If you want to be a live, okay, then what you can do is you can be a live on YouTube and you can do it. Or you may use some predefined screen recording software and you have pre-recorded sessions, and that sessions can be then floated onto the Google Classroom. So that is one thing you can do it. Second is the Moodle. Moodle is the best option. Like what the offer, I think the different providers are providing to you, they are doing the same thing. Like there is a Moodle, right? If you can manage a Moodle by your own, you don't require to purchase anything. Because through Moodle, you can float your videos, you can slot them schedule-wise, you can slot quiz schedule-wise. That is what one particular academician want, right? That I want to float my course on a specific time, or quiz must be on a specific time, then it will be auto-evaluated, there should be a statistics, then we can provide materials also, announcement also, so that everything can be handled in a freely available Moodle. Right? The only thing is we have to customize as per our requirement. And the same thing is there for the Google Classroom. So I don't think so we require to purchase anything. We can effectively manage everything through the free tools, which is freely available.
Yes. Okay.
And second question, sir, I would like to ask.
Yes.
As you said in the Google Classroom, there is a quiz. So we face some difficulties during our college exam, model exam.
Okay.
So I think the Google Classroom in quiz, there is a good for MCQ based questions. MCQ based questions we can give, and also mention answer key also. So there is difficulty with the descriptive questions. So when we give the descriptive questions, so many times the students cut, copy and paste, and they pasted the answer.
Okay.
So there is some solution for descriptive questions.
So for descriptive questions, one easiest solution is when you design MCQ, you can put some of the question as a descriptive question where students has to upload the file. So what we require to do is you have a questions, but then student has to write that questions in their notebook. They have to capture the photograph where the roll number, their sign, and their one page of description is there. And that photograph they have to upload as a part of that Google form. And what you will get is in your response, Google Form response, you will get that all the attached PDFs or photographs.
Okay.
And you can evaluate. You can evaluate like you are evaluating your physical copy.
Yeah.
It's almost similar to your physical copy. But the only thing is you are evaluating online. There you can see the handwritings where you can see that how he has or she has contributed. But this is what we have conducted at our university also. And you can easily find out that no one is like have a same copy of it.
Okay.
So this is one of the way, because Google, when you design a Google form, not only MCQ, you will have an option to have a descriptive questions, but where you require to provide the option called upload file.
Okay.
Don't type it. So when they upload in their handwriting, along with all the necessary informations, then it will be easy to identify and easy to assess.
Okay.
The only thing is Thank you. You can assess it manually. It will not be auto-evaluated.
Yes. It should be manually, yes.
Yes.
Thank you so much, sir.
Okay, sir. Another question is there.
Yes.
Sir, how to be a mentor in Swayam NPTEL course?
Okay, fine. Yes, course-wise, different mentor is there. It can be assigned. So what you require is, if you require to establish a chapter, which is called NPTEL chapter at your institute, and you establish a chapter, then there will be one coordinator. The coordinator can, every time, in every semester, they can assign course-wise mentor. That is something like as an admin person, and he or she has a rights to do everything. Right? So for example, from my college or university, if I am a coordinator, right? Generally, I think Vipin sir know that what generally used to happen is from nursing, if somebody wants to be a mentor, they just submit a name to me. Then for that course, I assign a mentor.
Okay.
Right? Being a coordinator, I do it. And then there will be an entire platform on which I can see that there are so many mentors, there are so many students, their scores, their assignments, their continuous evaluations, their progress, and everything can be tracked easily on an online platform, right? So for that you require to establish a local chapter at your institute, and it's very easy to do it. You have to just fill up a form and submit, and you will be easily fine. So if you have it, it's very easy to do it. But if you find any difficulty in that, then even if you have established and if you find any difficulty, you may ask ma'am, we will conduct another session on specifically that particular thing, no problem.
Okay. Another question is there, sir.
Yes.
For YouTube studio, there is requirement of any registration or license?
No. For YouTube studio, just log in on YouTube with your login ID. You start your channel, create channel. So your channel will be created, and one YouTube studio will be open where you can be live also. You can upload your video also. You can do everything at free of cost.
Okay.
Niro sir.
Yes, Vipin sir.
Very good session. Actually, always your sessions are extraordinary.
Thank you, sir.
And today you do the same thing here. So, sir, my question is that a lot of people are earning through the YouTube channels also.
Mm-hmm.
So, yes. What is the process for that?
Sir, there is no process, Vipin sir. What you can do is just log in into the YouTube with your existing account, Gmail account.
Yes, sir.
Right? And then you start your own channel. There will be in upper right corner, there will be an option like create a channel or start a channel. You can start your own channel. And once your channel has been started, it will already provide you the customized environment where you can either upload your video or you can live. You can set that I want to be a live at 9 o'clock at this particular date and time. And then you can be a live. And that live sessions will be then captured. Right?
One more, sir.
Yes.
Sir, what is the use difference between that Microsoft Teams and Edmodo? Whether both the functionality, I hope it is a common. So is it any basics difference between this?
No, they both are almost providing the same thing. But Edmodo is something which is a third party tool. So people want to believe on it or not, because they want to upload their content and they also want to see that whether this content will be available for a longer amount of time or not. That's why maybe people trust more on Microsoft, so use Microsoft. But they both are providing the same thing. Microsoft Teams is providing one extra thing is you, after logging into the Microsoft Teams, you can directly start your video sessions and you can directly have a webinar kind of session through that video lecture. Right? In case of Edmodo, it is not there.
Okay, so that's
Edmodo, I have considered that's why as a part of only teacher and student communications. You can just have a separate Edmodo account where you can keep all your communications and assignments and quiz and the statistics which is related to the students, right? And that is available to us. That we can take print out at any time and you can have all the collection of statistics which is related to that particular semester. Right. Whereas TV is something where you want to log in because every day you want to take new sessions, live sessions. So yes. Through team you can conduct and that can be done.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Okay, sir.
Okay, sir. Another question is there, sir.
Yes.
How to get a scholarship for a course? You said that Coursera and another foreign universities are offering. So is there any provision for scholarship? And
Some of the MOOCs provider are providing the scholarship, but that is purely based on your request. You have to send a request that where you are belong to, from where you are coming, why you want scholarship, whether you find any difficulty, are you a student, are you not an employee, and then you have to submit the form. Then your request will be evaluated by the whatsoever course provider, and maybe you will get. For example, nowadays, due to this pandemic situation, Coursera and all other providers are providing the free course. So you can also, being an institute coordinator, you just send a request to the Coursera, and all the courses which is provided right now by the Coursera will be free till this pandemic situation. And then after again, there will be a paid. But then they are also providing this kind of opportunity. Our many of the students, because our institute, for our university, it is free of cost. So yes, all sir. Students can get a benefit of it. Many of the students have certified many Coursera and many other certifications free of cost. And it is currently right now, again, free of cost.
Okay.
Till the end of the month of October. And then they may extend, depends on situations. Right? So that is one thing.
Sir, another question one delegate have.
Yes,
how to make our own blog site for easily communication or accessible PPT for the students?
For PPT?
Yes, in blog site, how to create a blog?
Blog is different than the PPT. If you want your PPT to be shared with your students, then it is better to create a class in the Google Classroom and share all your PPT. Or else you can use SlideShare. It's specifically made for sharing the slides with the specific group of students. Just for PPT, if you want to present and if you want to just share it, right? So blog is something different. Blog is, you can use many different blogs and sites are available, but that blog will not contain, I think blog is specifically for if you want to convey a specific content which is beyond your course, but which is like advanced content, and you want to communicate something different to your student, you can just plot it onto the blog. So blog is, I think, not suitable for the continuous activity. It is there, but it is for sharing your ideas, your views, your expression. Blog is always a faculty-wise or a person-wise. Being the person, you want to share something specialized from your side, right? While PPT and all this content are something which is, you want to plot it for all the students, and that is something which is more related to course. You have to either use the Google Classroom where you can create a class, enroll the students and share the PPTs. You can go to the, go through Edmodo, you can go through Microsoft Teams, right, which are available, and well-known tools are available to us. Or you can just upload your document on SlideShare, where not only your students, right, in the throughout the entire world, anyone can see and can view and can give your comments on the SlideShare. You can upload freely on the SlideShare.
Yes. So thank you once again, sir.
Nirav, sir, one more thing.
Vipin, sir.
Sir, currently, we have enrolled for 2-3 courses, but still the exams are pending. Actually, final exams.
About
due to
which
this,
course?
There are 2-3 courses are there that is belongs to this medical sciences.
Okay.
On this NPTEL. So their exams
NPTEL
are pending.
So yes, sir.
What is the expected date? Something information you have regarding that?
So that is along with this semester's exam, that is December.
Okay.
So they are planning to have exams on December along with the semester exams.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Okay.
Okay, anyone have any question?
I hope this session is useful to those who are right now live in these sessions, and I have at least fulfilled up to some extent what, madam, is it your expectation or something what you were expecting to?
Yes, sir, definitely. No, it's really very much informative, and we have also some doubts before your session, but throughout your session we have cleared our doubts.
Okay, fine. That's really very good for us.
Yes, sir.
Okay. But even future, if you find any doubts, then you may contact madam, and madam already have my contacts, and just slot it to me, then we'll solve.
Sure, sir. Thank you. Thank you so much. Now it's time for a vote of thanks. I take this opportunity to thank everyone for agreeing attending this webinar as a faculty development program on LMS, preparation of e-courses, videos, lectures, and demonstration organized by IQSC, Jinsa Patel College of Nursing, Nadiad. First, I would like to convey my sincere gratitude to our today's resource person, Mr. Nirav Bhatt, sir, Assistant Professor of Department of IT at Chandubhai S. Patel Institute of Technology, Charset. Sir, we are really very thankful to you for your valuable time and remarkable sharing of knowledge. Thank you so much, sir. I thank to our respected Director, Dr. B.S. Sales, sir, Principal, Mr. Virendra Jain, sir, and Vice Principal and IQSC Coordinator, Mrs. Arpita Vaid, ma'am, for giving me this opportunity as a moderator of this webinar. My special thanks to our Assistant Professor, Mr. Kailas Nagar, sir, for technical support. I thank all the delegates for your participation. You all will get e-certificate for this webinar FDP within 3 days. Thank you once again.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you for this opportunity, and it's very good to meet all of you.
Thank you so much. Yes.